Hi. Shabbat Shalom, everyone. We'd like to remind all of you of a couple of details for tonight's service. Tonight's service is being recorded, and if you do not wish to be recorded, you may rename yourself or simply turn off your video. We will be using closed captioning. You may turn it off at the bottom of your Zoom screen if you do not wish to see it. And if you would be so kind as to please mute yourselves unless you are called upon. We're very happy that you're here for tonight's Shabbat service. Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
So I would hope that you're all, opening your hearts to Shabbat and letting go of all the pressures of your week and enjoying this version of Simple Gifts to start your Shabbat with some gratitude.
Tis the gift to be simple, tis the gift to be free, tis the gift to come down where you want to be. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, 'twill be in the valley of love and delight. When true simplicity is gained, to bow and to bend, we will not be ashamed. To turn will be our delight, till by turning we come round right. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, 'twill be in the valley of love and delight. When true simplicity is gained, to bow and to bend, we will not be ashamed. To turn will be our delight, till by turning we come round right.
Thank you.
Behold how good and how pleasant it is when brethren dwell together in harmony.
Sarah will lead us by lighting the candles. If you have candles in your home, feel free to join.
Amen.
Lachadodi likrav kala Panei Shabbat Nekabela Lecha Dodi Lekrat Kala Panei Shabbat Nekabela Shamor Vizachor Pedebur Echad Ish Mianu El Hamuchad Adonai Echad Ushmo Echad Leshem El Tuferes Eliti Tehi Hila
Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala Panei Shabbat Nekabela Likrat Shabbat Nechuven Yelcha Ki Hi Mekor HaBracha Mi Rosh Mi Kedem Nesucha Sof Maaseh B'machshavatila
Lecha Dodi Likrat Kala Panei Shabbat Nekabela it ori, kvirech, uri, 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 shir davari, evod Adonai, al yechem mekla.
Lecha dodi likrat kala, p'nei shabbat nikabela, bo'i v'shalom atet ala, Gamrina utelacha, tokemune amsegula, boi kala, boi kala,
leka, gamdi,
leka, kala, bene, shabbat, neka, bela.
Kola kavod.
Toda rava.
So I'm going to do the Chatzi Kaddish in English, and then I thought you'd enjoy the voice on this recording more than our disharmony, so get with us. Exalted and hallowed be God's great name in the world which God created according to plan. May God's majesty be revealed in the days of our lifetime and the life of all Israel, speedily, imminently, to which we say, Amen. Blessed be God's great name to all eternity. Blessed, praised, honored, exalted, extolled, glorified, adored, and lauded be the name of the Holy Blessed One, beyond all earthly words and songs of blessing, praise, and comfort, to which we all say, Amen.
Yitkadal v'yitkadash shemei rabbah. Be'alma divarach yirutei v'yamlich malchutei b'chayechon v'yomechon uv'chaye dechol beit Yisrael b'agala b'agala uv'izman kariv v'imeru amen yeheshme rabba mevarach Le'alam u'alme almaya Yitzbarach, yitzbarach ve'yishtabach Vitzpa'ar v'yitromam v'yitnasei Ve'yitadar v'yitale v'yitalal Shemei dekut shabrichu Le'ela min kol birchata v'shirata Tushbechata v'nechemata Da'amiran be'alma Ve'imeru Amen.
Please rise for the Baruch Hu.
Et Adonai Hamvora Baruch Adonai Hamvorach Le'olam Ba'ed.
Blessed are you, Adonai, our God, ruler of the universe, who speaks the evening into being, skillfully opens the gates, thoughtfully alters the time and changes the seasons, and arranges the stars in their heavenly courses according to plan. You are creator of day and night, rolling light away from darkness and darkness from light, transforming day into night and distinguishing one from the other. But Tzviot is your own name. Ever-living God, may you reign continually over us into eternity. Blessed are you, Adonai, who brings on evening. Baruch atah Adonai, amariv arabim.
Amen.
So this is a prayer for everlasting love and reverence for the Torah. And please enjoy this Jason Mraz rendition of Ahuvat Olam. If you wouldn't mind reading this poem by Rabbi Rachel Barenblatt, we would really appreciate it. Thank you.
Hard act to follow. Dear one, you love me so much, you give me your Torah for argument and play, waltzing and conversation from one life to the next. Your Torah nourishes me, familiar as the womb. Wrap me tight in your Torah like a newborn. Laugh and delight when I learn to break free. Your Torah lights up my eyes, fuses my heart with my choices. Give me just one letter to suck like candy, like manna, changing flavor on my tongue. tell me a true story again about who I used to be or who I might yet be, like you always becoming, who you are becoming. Beloved, draw me close. I've been scattered. Melt me until we mingle. I want to come home in you. Choose me again. Don't stop.
Great. Thank you, Holly.
Wow.
Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad.
Baruch Shem Kavod Malchuto Le'olam Va'ed. Ve'ahavta et Adonai Elohecha v'chol levavcha v'chol nafshecha v'chol me'odecha v'chayu hadvarim ha'ele asher anohi mitzavcha hayom al levavecha v'shinantam levanecha v'dibarta bam v'shivtecha b'veitecha uv'lechtecha v'aderech v'shokbecha v'kumecha v'chshartam le'ot al yadecha v'chayu letotafot bein einecha v'chtavtam am zot beitecha u'vishareha. Leman peace karu v'asitem et kol mitzvotai v'yitem kadoshim l'elohim. Ani Adonai Elohehem asher hotziti etchem me'eretz Mitzrayim v'hiyot lachem l'elohim. Ani Adonai Elohehem.
Perhaps in the next prayer, which is Nihamoka, just before we transition to our personal prayers of request in the Amidah, we are meant not just to be grateful that we are free and that God has freed us, but also to think hard about what we will do with our freedom. What will we make of the precious gift of our lives and freedom to make choices? What will we request of God during the Amidah? How do our personal prayers for ourselves and our families link to our prayers for our community? Written by Leo Fuchs from Congregation Emmanuel in San Francisco. With that, we'll bring you another non-Royan Sarah version of Nihamocha.
Nihamocha, ba'eli madonai. Mi chamocha nedar bakodesh nora tehilo o sefele nora tehilo sefele mi chamocha ba eli madona mi chamocha nedar bakodesh nora tehilo o sefele nora tehilo o sefele. Repeat after me. Mahutecha ra'u banecha bokei hayam lifne Moshe u'Miriam ze'eli, eli anu ve'ameru Adonai im lov le'olam ba'er yalla layla yalla layla layla yalla layla 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 yalla layla yalla layla layla yalla layla Who is like you? Who is like you? Who is like you, Adonai? Who is like you? Who is like you? Who is like you, Adonai? Mi chamocha, mi chamocha, ba'eli madonai. Mi chamocha, nedar bakodesh nora tehilo, o sefele. Nora tehilo, o sefele. Malchutecha, malchutecha. Ra'u banecha, bokei hayam, bokei hayam. Lifne Moshe u'Miriam, ze'eli. Eli anu ve'ameru Adonai imloch le'olam ba'eh le'tzir yalais yalla layla yalla layla layla yalla layla 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 layla
V'shamru b'nei Yisrael et ha-Shabbat la'zot et ha-Shabbat le'dorotam b'ritova.
Adonai, open up my lips that my mouth may declare your praise.
Baruch ata Adonai Magen Avraham Ezrat Sarah. Ata Gibor Leolam Adonai Mechayei Mitim Ata Rav Loshia Mechalkel Chayim Bechesed Mechayei Mitim Berachamim Amim Shomeit Lotim Berofeh Olim Umatir Asurim Kayem and Nato di Shane Afar, Mihamo Habal, who wrote, Umi Dome Lach, Melech Nemit, Kaye, Umat Mia Kushuma, Veneman Natale Hayot, Nitim, Baruchata Adonai, Mehaye Hamitim. Ata kadosh v'simcha hakadosh u'kloshim b'chol yom k'chal b'rucha sela b'rucha ta Adonai ha'el hakadosh.
So now we come to the prayer for peace, which comes in many forms, and here is a new way for you to enjoy it without our voices.
Shalom Rav, aleinu tasim leolam. Shalom Rav, aleinu tasim leolam. O source of all that is, help us to know nations as one, each as our own. Shalom Rav, aleinu tasim leolam. Shalom Rav, aleinu tasim leolam. O source of life. Open up our eyes that we may see justice is light. Shalom Rav, Aleinu Tassim, Leolam Shalom Rav, Aleinu Tassim, Leolam. In every season, in every hour, God bless the people, taking back the power, bringing it to the streets, serving those in need, doing the holy work until we all are free. Bringing it to the streets, serving those in need, doing the holy work until we all are free. Shalom Rav, Aleinu Tassim, Leolam. 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 Shalom Rav, Aleinu Tassim, Leolam.
Who says shalom b'mramah? Who yaseh shalom aleinu ve'kol Yisrael ve'al kol yoshei tevil v'imru imru amen. May the one who makes peace in the high heaven make peace for us, for all Israel, and all who inhabit the earth. Amen. Now for the highlight of the evening, my wife gets to give the devar.
Terrible. This week's parashat is Ki Tetzeh, which is Deuteronomy chapter 21, verse 10 through chapter 25. The portion addresses domestic life and human interactions. And the text presents concrete instructions on correct action in specific situations. While many of the particular circumstances don't exactly mimic our modern lives, the clear theme of just actions toward others, whether those others are our enemies or our friends, and regardless of their social status, is very applicable today. The verses in Ki Tetzeh outline a societal structure of trust based on three things. The first is the care of others, particularly the needy. Examples of this from the text include the instructions to pay the laborer's wages on the day the work is performed so that he can provide for himself, the prohibition on taking a person's means of livelihood, the particular example is not taking the millstone, as payment for a debt or collateral for a loan, and the direction to not go back into the field to pick up a forgotten sheaf of wheat, nor to beat the olive trees twice, but to leave food in the fields for the poor to glean. The second principle is just and fair treatment of others. The text specifies that the favored son may not be given the birthright portion over the firstborn, but less favored son, that lost property must be protected and returned to the owner, that sons shall not be punished for their father's offenses, nor fathers punished for the offenses of their sons. The third pillar for society in the text is minimizing suffering. Examples of these mitzvot are the directions to shoo a bird away from a nest before taking the fledglings or the eggs, not yoking a stronger and a weaker animal together, and taking care to build one's house with a parapet around the roof to prevent falls. There are numerous ways that we can observe these mitzvot in our contemporary lives. One public expression of them that I would like to bring to your attention tonight is the prison abolition movement in the United States. First, a little background. The U.S. has the highest per capita incarceration rate of any nation at 698 people per 100,000 residents. Poor people are incarcerated at a much higher rate than middle-income or wealthy people. And whites are underrepresented and blacks overrepresented in the incarcerated population compared to their percentages in the general population. Across the country, policies such as cash bail combined with long trial delays effectively incarcerate people charged with crimes for months before they are tried or convicted of anything. This prevents accused people from contributing to the support of their families and from participating in their communities, worsening the situations of those families and those communities. These stresses and limited legal defense options, whether those are public or private defense, can lead the accused to accept plea agreements in hopes of returning quickly to their homes. But upon return to the community, opportunities for employment and housing are limited for the formerly incarcerated, whether or not they were convicted of a crime. Looking at the situation from a different perspective, public safety, which is currently conceptualized as police, firefighters, and corrections facilities, is a valued government priority. In times of austerity, our willingness as a society to devote government, meaning tax dollars, to social welfare programs shrinks, while the willingness to preserve public safety spending shrinks less or doesn't shrink at all. This in turn drives workers looking for stable employment towards those areas that are defined as public safety, whether that is directly to a job as a corrections officer or a court officer, or indirectly as, for example, communities lobbying to have a prison built near or within them, with the expectation that the prison will drive other economic activity into the community and improve the community. The prison abolition movement seeks to radically reorganize this landscape. Academics and activists such as Ruth Gilmore, Angela Davis, Michelle Alexander, and others are working towards a goal of not simply closing prisons, but of putting into place and maintaining the policies of investing in education, jobs, housing, and health, including mental health care, that are needed for productive and violence-free lives. The individual areas of organizing range from opposing new prison construction to improving schools, from protecting the environment to strengthening the social safety net. There's also work in progress on transforming how the justice system responds to offenses from our current punitive stance towards a rehabilitative one. The dictates in Ki Tetzeh are described by the traditional commentators, as radical for their time. I imagine that many of us have a hard time imagining a time when our society is completely without prisons. In the spirit of this week's parashat, however, we might consider other structural changes that we can make to support and protect those in our community. One of these is CBS's push towards a new model of financial support for our congregation, terumah, giving from the heart. Not every member of our congregation can afford fixed dues. In order to be equitable and in order to be just, we need to welcome anyone who wants to partake of what CBS has to offer, giving that opportunity to every member of our community, regardless of their financial means. And I would add, inviting all members of our community to share their gifts with our community, whether those are financial gifts or gifts of service. In this way, we are following the spirit of justice repeatedly demonstrated in Keith Take Say. Please vote to support the recently distributed bylaws changes, which will allow CBS to embrace Tuluma and to offer equitable access to all CBS has to offer. Open your heart and support a congregation that opens its heart. Roy and I wish you all a peaceful Shabbat.
Thank you, Sarah. With that, we lead to the announcements, which Bob will read for us.
Thank you very much, Sarah. I appreciate the thoughtfulness in the Devar. The announcements, we want a special thank you to Roy and Sarah for leading tonight's service and for sharing your singing as well as the special song you brought to us. And tomorrow morning's Torah study at 9 o'clock will be led by Hank Lander, and the link is on the email that was sent out. And next week, David and Sherry Meyer are going to be leading us in the Shabbat services at 7 p.m. And I want to put a special note in for the food fair. The baking events have begun. A special huge thank you to Lynn Snyder and Robin Ash, who've been organizing the baking. And I just want to say, I went online to the,
the order form?
Not the order form, but to help. The,
oh. And the sign up app? The Genius
the sign up. That's right, sign up. Sign up Genius.
Okay.
And it's very simple to do the sign up Genius. And so I signed up to bake some of the apple cakes. And then I signed up to help on October 23rd and 24th. When we're going to be packing everybody's bags. And I noticed that people haven't signed up yet for that. It's a long ways in the future, but still, if you could go on the Sign Up Genius, if you are going to be around those 2 days and come in for 2 hours or 3 hours and put your name in, then it will help us plan ahead. One of the things that always seems to happen is that people wait till the last minute to order. And if we do that, then we won't be able to have enough cake, apple cakes, or anything else. So we'd like for you to order now, even though it seems like it's a long time in the future again. I know I'm going to forget what I ordered, but I will have a reminder email. But it really does help us. If you do that now, we'll be able to continue baking and cooking, and everyone will get what they want. So the next baking date is the 25th of August at 9 a.m. with Robin Ash. And if you watch your emails and check the website for volunteer opportunities, you can use the Sign Up Genius. And again, it's quite easy to use. And again, place your orders. We would certainly appreciate that through the website.
And if anybody wants to help me make macaroons, I would appreciate that help too. You can get in touch with me.
Okay. Then the Shama registration is open, and this is for our youth, our children, our young ones. And you can sign up again online, and it starts September 12th, a Sunday. And we will be excited to have all the children and youth as part of that program. And finally, if you're visiting with us tonight and would like to be on our email list, put your name and email in the chat, and I will write it down. And I'll make sure that we get in touch and we can tell you a little bit more about Beth Shalom and put you on our mailing list. We'd enjoy being in touch with you that way. Thank you very much for being here tonight. And again, thank you to Roy and to Sarah. Okay.
So as we move into the Mishnah Berach, the prayer for healing, please chat into the chat box any names of those who are in need of healing, or you can unmute yourself and say their names aloud.
Meredith Rose.
Lauren Depp. Arnie. Celia Kessler. Melody Klein. Victoria Olbrook. Patty Lau. Marcy Lee. Margie Lee. Joe Monty.
Se'ela
Bat Chaya Aida
and Yossi Ben Se'ela.
Smidge Davidson.
Joe Monty, Judy Matat, Jack Rasa, and again to save you from hearing Sarah and I in disharmony, we have another recording for you, beautiful Michelle Darrow. Tony Maynard, another name.
Sylvia Wexler.
Elena, please rise.
Elena, the Shabbat August, my teeth could have all your separated. Shallow, our son who could go, yeah, our soul. Below, someone who keeps for Kotadama. Shallow, some hell came in Kahan. Big old, our lady who could hold our monarch. I not in Korean, Mishtachabim, Mugim, Lifne Melech, Malte Halachim, Hakadosh Baruch Hu. Uno Teshamayim, Beyoset Ares, Rumoshe Vekaro, Veshamayim, Mimahal, Ushmina Tuzo, Ushmina Tuzo, Evav Hemen, Omin. Who Eloheinu ein od, emet malkeinu efesulato, kakadu betorato, biadat hayom, hashevotai
elokha,
ki Adonai hu Elohim, hashamayim vimah, Be all hearts, me, the heart, and heart, the name, the higher Adonai, the Melech, 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 the There's another reading. Human life is sacred, adopted from Trudy Weiss Rosmarin. Biblical, Talmudic, and rabbinic literature emphasize that every human being has infinite value by virtue of being endowed with a spark of the divine, in whose image all are created. To degrade people thus becomes tantamount to degrading God. Wrong inflicted upon anyone thus becomes a transgression against God, and one who sheds blood diminishes something from the likeness of which all are made. Lest one assume that God sorrows, as it were, only for the hurt inflicted upon the righteous, the sages stress that the Holy One mourns for the blood of the sinners, for they too are God's children. Every human life is sacred because every individual partakes of the holiness of God.
As we go into the Kaddish, I'll read the names of those who have passed in the last 11 months. Please add additional names into the chat or unmute to say those names after I've read this list of any others who have passed recently. Dennis Matat, Sandra Jeffrey, Bill Jenkins, Nancy Ann Sutter, Charlie Hilty, Marie Fink, Maria Pellegrino Eisner, Sheila Sugarman, Nancy Norton Fleischman, Raul Saavedra, Leroy Davis, Sarah Everard, Christine Verano, Anne Kilcrease, Gloria Doty, Susan Bloom, Jerome Marvin Hyman, Ivan Krakowski, Michael Salman, Dean Myrtle, Frank Ketchell, Patrick Ashley, Alfredo Laniato, and Beatrice Massad.
Peter Ulbrich.
Arnziana Carvajal.
Next slide, Rick. I also read those yahrzeit, those with anniversaries of their passing at this time of year. Herschel Fears, grandfather of Brenda Baskerville, Norman Glenn, father of Jeffrey Glenn, Joseph Hirsch, the father of Lane Hirsch, Sylvia Hirsch, mother of Lauren Hirsch, Saul Calamaris, father of Fifi Pakel, and Alex Wexler, father-in-law of Sylvia Wexler, and grandfather of Rabbi Nancy Wexler. There are additional names. Again, feel free to unmute and say them aloud or put them into the chat box. And I encourage you all to unmute yourselves as we say the morning Kaddish and rise as one community.
Amen.
Forward, back, and inside.
So, in the congregation where Sarah and I came when we lived in Connecticut. There was a tradition on the bar bat mitzvah on Friday nights that the or on Saturday mornings that the bar bat mitzvah would choose the tune to Adon Olam, which we always used as our tune, and it became somewhat of a competition to find unusual and new tunes for that to be played. So Sarah and I had a hard time choosing because we found many, but we hope that you will enjoy this version of Adon Olam.
Adon Olam, Asher Malach, B'Terem Kol Yetzir Nivra, V'Yein Nasa V'Chesu Kol, Adai Melech Shemo Nikra, Adon Olam, Asher Malach, B'Terem Kol Yetzir Nivra,
I hope that made you all happy.
For the health coverage you need close to home, lean on Molina Health.
And if not, you can go to Molina.
Healthcare. Molina has 40 years of experience caring for people across the U.S. with access to quality care for moms, kids, and families. Molina provides.
This service brought to you by Molina Healthcare. With that, we'll go to the
Kiddush.
The Kiddush. Aruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Horei Pari Hagafen. Aruch atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Kishonu B'Mitzvotah Baruch Zavanu V'Shavat Kachov Yavam Nikadesh HaShabbat. Amen.
Amen.
And in anticipation of the food fair and the baking that I've been done, helping with the mini nuts, which are date-filled pinwheels, today I made a homemade challah that has, I don't know if you can see it, two of the three braids. Were made with maninas, but because I think chocolate makes everything better, the third braid was made with chocolate. And so with that, Sarah will say the blessing over the bread. Shabbat shalom, everybody. And Rick, feel free to put us on gallery view. I wanted to say we're looking forward to the rabbi returning and leading us in services, but we were glad to have the opportunity, and we wish you all a Shabbat Shalom.
And special thank you to Rick for the tech support.
Thank you, Rick.
We couldn't have done it without him.
Shabbat Shalom, everyone.
Thank you. Shabbat
Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom.
Shabbat Shalom. Thank you.
Karen, nice to have you with us.
It's our tour study.
There was somebody else who asked.
Yeah.
Thank you both.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great.
Okay. Bye.
If you'd like some information, let
me
know.
That's a
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.
Shabbat shalom.